water supply for 24 hours does not involve only pumping. It starts from raw water. To ride over power disruptions, there are two methods which we are following. Number one, we are taking cables directly from the main power station to the water supply, like OPA, one solution. And the second solution is extra quantity of pumping capacity. Get a proper consultant and an agency to do this mapping, because I don't think the PWD will be able to do the full mapping in a short time. So we can have a third party agency to carry out full analysis and then bring this all on record. So that can be done. But 152 plus 15, 167 MLD water plants under process. There are 622 MLD water capacity is there. 10% out of it goes for backwash. So it is about 560 available, and water supply to the various constituencies areas comes out to be about 500. So about 10% is lost on the way, 10 to 11%, which is a reasonable transmission loss. Mahisar 10, OPA 27 should be commissioned by December. This is mainly for Tiswadi. Mahisar 10, which will be commissioned by September. Osnora 30, already tender floated. Chandel 15, Tuye 30, Porvori 15, Tankona 5, Gaune at Gaune. Sar 10, Padoshe 10, and Giri Atavuzun, yeah, on the final on the Zagayatir, 15. 167 MLD water is being done. As of now, Goa has adequate water. Leakage is amka tharong jai. So pipelines will have to be changed, because in some areas, AC pipelines, tail end pipelines are AC pipeline, which breaks. So we will have to replace those pipelines stepwise.
CM Parrikar gave his assurance that for those constituencies encumbered by ongoing JICA works, the same will be completed by
2019. I expect by 2019 JICA work to get over.
Siglanso Datiklo.
HCN Bureau Report.